Hi folks, how you doing? My name is Steve Zielinski. I am the founder of Crazy Steve's Pickles and Salsa. This is our video, and this is our story. Thanks for watching. In July 2009, I started making pickles and salsa from our home garden. It was a really big hit with our family, friends, co-workers. This wound up becoming the birth of Crazy Steve's Pickles and Salsa. Over the next 6 months, I started creating different types of varieties of pickles and salsa, which were gluten-free, vegan-friendly, low-sodium. They were all natural ingredients, unique flavors, and we used them in cooking as well as just on their own. I think things should be fun. If it's not fun, why do it? To quote Ben and Jerry. I wanted to create this product that would be funny and at the same time spark a thought, make you think, educate, inspire, and contribute to life. Pretty big order for a jar of pickles. Woodstock. 3 days of peace and music was held from August 15th to August 18th, 1969. The organizers planned on 200,000 people attending. In the end, 500,000 attended. Another million had to turn back because of traffic. Hearing there was a shortage of food, members of the Monticello Jewish Community Center made sandwiches with 200 loaves of bread, 40 pounds of meat cuts, and 2 gallons of pickles, which were distributed by nuns. Obviously, they were a little short on pickles. Our flavors are a little bit more than half sour. It's a barrel style like a New York deli style pickle. We have one that's a little sweet, little sour. It's a dill pickle, almost like a gherkin. Our Cajun Cuke is made with fresh jalapeno, onion, celery. There's 18 different spices that go into this pickle. Also makes a really nice dirty martini or a great Bloody Mary. We make a bread and butter style pickle called Let the Sunshine, and his brother is called Let the Insane Sunshine. It's sweet and hot, goes great on cheeseburgers, grilled cheese, or deli sandwiches. For salsas, we make our mango raspberry salsa, which we'll put on chicken, pork chops, or tilapia. Black bean and corn is our most popular. Our newest concoction is a cranberry habanero. We'll marinate pork tenderloin in this. We'll put it on grilled salmon, turkey, or warm brie. We make a green smoking salsa made with a tomatilla. It's got like a lime citrusy type flavor. We'll use that as a dipping sauce for scallops or shrimp. That, a pitcher of margaritas, Jimmy Buffett playing in the background, a hammock, a sunset, you're pretty good to go. Our last but not least is our mesquite fire roasted salsas, which we make in medium, hot, or insane.
Hey guys, how you doing? This is Crazy Steve here in Delaware at Peppers on the Beach. And we're doing, today we're doing a review of our insane version of our mango raspberry.
It's good. It's a good salsa. All right, garlic. Tomato comes in right away. Mm-hmm. Beautiful smoky flavor. Heat's on the back end. Really good. Very right. Good.
So thumbs up?
Absolutely.
All right.
Absolutely.
Thumbs up.
Pickles, this is our newest concoction here. This is our Let the Insane Sunshine. It's a sweet, like a bread and butter style pickle, but what we did is we infused it with habanero peppers in the brine, so you got a little sweet with a lot of heat there.
Nice bread and butter pickle consistency, I like that. It's got a nice heat building, but not that bad at all, but flavor-wise, it's right up my alley. I enjoy that one.
Really tasty. I taste more sweet than hot.
Yep.
Definitely the bread and butter pickle is a good description. That would be excellent on a cheeseburger, I can tell you that. Sweetness right up front. Great, crisp pickle.
Yeah, I like that too. You don't want a soggy pickle, do you?
No. And I read the ingredients. It does. You don't use pickle crisps or anything like that.
Natural stuff.
Yeah, and to get a product like that crisp, nice work, man.
Last year I started a cause called Pickles Against World Hunger, which I was able to get Mario Batali to sign 5 of our jars for. Okay, folks, here's the deal. We are currently in about 30 different grocery stores, small mom-and-pop shops, some beer and wine places, and we just had Whole Foods in New Jersey. 2 locations are interested in our product. So hopefully by next month we're going to be in there.
and this is where I need your help. Currently, we're manufacturing it on our own after hours in a commercial kitchen. So we're not getting in there until like about 7 o'clock at night, not getting out till like 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, and then we're going out and selling. And I can't keep up with the current demand, which is a good thing. And this is where you come in. What we're looking to do is we have two co-packers that are looking at our product, that are looking to manufacture it for us, which will be terrific. To do the pickles, we're looking at about $12,000 to $15,000 to get the first run done, and the salsas would be another about $12,000 to $15,000. So initially, what I'm looking for is at least if we get the pickle started, that would be great. So with a contribution of $25, we will ship you out 3 jars of pickles and salsa anywhere in the United States. For $60, we'll ship out 8 jars of pickles and salsa. For $90, we'll include our Peace, Love, and Pickles Tour 2011 t-shirt. So we got a lot more information if you'd like, right down there. And we appreciate all your contributions. And just click on the button right over there. Thanks again for supporting our project. Watching the sun bake.